Hello friends and welcome to DigiMento. Today we will be discussing about the target of meeting zero hunger by 2030. As we all know, this is one among the goals of Sustainable Development Goals. So under the Sustainable Development Goals, we have 17 goals, out of which the second goal is zero hunger. That is to eliminate hunger by the year 2030. So 2030 is the year by which we have to achieve all the 17 sustainable development goals, and we will be particularly looking at the second goal in this lecture. Today we will see what is the progress that India has achieved, what are the current trends, contemporary trends in India, and whether we will be able to achieve this target. So since this is a social issue, since this is related to poverty, it has many impacts, like sociological impact or social impact is very, very high. And also, this also has a linkage with education. There is enough scope that this can be asked in the examination in the general awareness session. So we will be looking at it in detail. So let's begin the video. Let's begin the lecture. But before that, this is our channel. And if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel. And also please press the bell icon to get the notifications of the videos that we upload on this channel, and share this video with your friends if you like this video. And we are providing GET, GATE, NTA, UGC NET and PGT Computer Science online courses. And for getting more details about the online courses, you can visit our website www.digimento.com, or you can call to any of these, this number, either call or you can WhatsApp. Okay, so let's start. So as we said, achieving zero hunger. So this target of zero hunger by 2030. So this is a sustainable development goal number 2. So sustainable development goals, it is a set of 17 goals adopted by the United Nations, the members of the UN, and the target is 2030. It started from 2015. So within a period of 15 years, starting from 2015, that is when the Millennium Development Goals came to an end. So from 2015 to 2030, over a period of 15 years, we have to achieve this target, the second goal under the SDGs. So the world has made great progress in reducing hunger. So let's see what is the statistics, what is the number. Now there are 216 million fewer hungry people than in 1990-92. Now we were able to eliminate hunger by 216 million. So 216 million reduction in hunger compared to 1990-92 levels, despite a 1.9 billion increase in the world's population. Now, another factor we have to consider here is that we were able to reduce 216 million fewer hungry people, or a reduction in hunger by 216 million people, at a time when the world has experienced a 1.9 billion increase in the population. So world's population increased by 1.9 billion, in which we have achieve this target, or we have achieved so far. In 2000, in the year 2000, the country was ranked as 83 out of 113 countries. So this is the case of India. So our country had the rank of 83 out of 113 countries in the year 2000, whereas in 2018 India was ranked 103 out of 119 countries, and now with 119 countries, we are at the rank of 103. So this is the rank of India. So 103 out of 119 as of 2018. A holistic approach to food security requires ensuring available, accessible, nutritious food to eradicate hunger and malnutrition in India. So we need a holistic approach to food security, and this requires availability of food, accessibility and nutritious food. So one is availability of food commodities, another one is accessibility of food commodities, third one is nutrition, that is quality of food. So third one is quality, okay, to eradicate hunger and malnutrition in India. The SDGs, the Sustainable Development Goals, aim to end all forms of hunger and malnutrition by 2030, making sure all people, especially children, have sufficient nutritious food all year. So SDG, it just not only concentrates or focuses on hunger, merely providing food, but it also focuses on providing nutritious food. Now here, nutrition means access to micronutrients. Now, if there is an absence of micronutrients in the diet of a person, this is a situation known as hidden hunger. So hidden hunger is nothing but the absence of micronutrients. Now, what are micronutrients? Micronutrients are vitamins and minerals. So vitamins and minerals constitute your micronutrients, and absence of micronutrients in your diet is known as a situation called hidden hunger. A very, very important term. So what is hidden hunger? So this is the absence of micronutrients such as vitamins and minerals. So sustainable development goal just not focus on providing food or providing with food resources, but nutritious food. This is because we should not only eradicate hunger but also malnutrition. Malnutrition is absence of nutrition. Okay, I hope you got it. Now let's come to the major concerns in India in achieving this target, that is zero hunger by 2030. The first problem is malnutrition. Now, malnutrition is characterized by two components, that is wasting and stunting. Now, what is wasting and what is stunting? Wasting means lesser weight according to the age. So for an age group, when the children or when any person, according to the age, if a person does not have adequate weight, this is called wasting. Now, stunting means height. So absence of inadequate or sorry, adequate. So absence of adequate height according to the age is called stunting. And these are two important factors which will expose the malnutrition levels. So stunting and wasting, these are two parameters with which we can check the malnutrition level in a country. Now, according to a joint report of UNICEF, the World Health Organization and World Bank, wasting prevalence in 2017 was estimated at almost 8% across the world. And out of this 8% across the world, that is 8% of children across the world have the problem of wasting, that is lesser weight as according to the age. Now, within this 8% of children globally, 2/3, that is 2/3 of this 8%. So 2/3 of this 8%, they are from Asia region. So Asia region is important for us because India also belongs to this region. So a majority of the children, according to the World Bank and the World Health Organization, who has this problem of wasting belongs to Asia region, in which India is also a part of. Now, food nourishment, this is the second problem. So food nourishment, there are 821 million people estimated to be chronically undernourished as of 2017, and over 90 million children under the age of 5 years are dangerously affected by these three symptoms, that is underweight, undernourishment and severe food insecurity. The prevalence of undernourishment is rising in South Asia from 9.4% in 2015 to 11.5% in 2016. So these are some of the statistics, these are some of the numbers which will expose to us the numbers. Okay, so this will help us to know what is the real picture. Now, another one is food wastage. So on the other hand, when we have a part of the country or the globe without adequate food, there is also another part to it, that there is also high level of food wastage happening around the globe. And according to FAO, FAO is UN, an agent of UN. So FAO is Food and Agricultural Organization, which is a UN agency. So according to Food and Agricultural Organization of the UN, the global volume of food wastage is estimated at 1.6 billion tons of primary product equivalents. Ending food waste is therefore very important in achieving zero hunger by 2030. And in India also, we have this problem of food wastage. This is especially seen in the agricultural sector. Why? Because there is lesser storage facilities, there is lesser transportation facilities. Because of lesser infrastructural facilities, better infrastructure will include everything, the logistics and infrastructure. So because of lack of infrastructure and logistic facilities, even in India's agricultural sector, there is a high rate of food wastage. Now, if we talk about the trends in food production, how the food production is carried out in the world, the major reasons for reduced food production are environmental degradation, drought, and biodiversity loss. So these are certain environmental factors which has happened due to the man-made activities or developmental activities undertaken by the human beings, which has directly impacted the agricultural sector and the food production in the country and all over the world. Now, what we have to do in order to achieve this goal of zero hunger by 2030? So to achieve this goal, we have to meet certain targets. So first one is to double the productivity. So by increasing the productivity, the food production will increase. And also there is a need to increase the income of small scale food producers. The small scale food producers here refers to small and marginal farmers. So we need to increase the productivity and the income levels. Next is sustainable food production and resilient agricultural practices. Now, what is meant by sustainable food production? It refers to carrying out agricultural activities without causing a damage to the environment. Now, third one is to maintain the genetic diversity in the food production. So, genetic diversity in food production has to be maintained. Fourth is to invest in rural infrastructure, agricultural research, technology, and gene banks. So, investment in rural infrastructure, that is connectivity, roads, storage facilities, anything, logistics, etc. Agricultural research in order to bring out more productive varieties of crops and use of technology, gene banks, etc. Next is prevent agricultural trade restrictions. That is to adopt a policy of open and free trade. Market distortions should be avoided and export subsidies should be avoided to a greater extent. So agricultural trade restrictions, market distortions and export subsidies should be eliminated or should be regulated to a larger extent. Ensure stable food commodity markets and timely access to information. So access to information for the producers and ensuring stable commodity market. That means price stability. So these are some of the measures or targets that we need to achieve the goal of zero hunger by 2030. Now, we will see the hunger in India from Indian scenario. So in India, there are 3 in 10 standard children are Indians. So which means if we take 10 standard children globally, 3 are from India. Standing means lesser height as compared to the age. Over 40% of the total Indian workforce is employed in the agricultural sector. So a majority, more than 40%, almost half of Indian population or Indian workforce is engaged in the primary sector or in agricultural activities. And 53% of women between 15 to 49 years are anemic. So this is another scenario. More than half of women between the 15 to 49 years. So why this period is taken? This is the productive age of women. So during the productive age, more than half of the women are anemic. Next is over 80% of infant and young children do not get minimum dietary diversity. Dietary diversity means diverse food commodities in the diet of a person. And if global food prices double, India could lose up to $49 billion in the GDP. Now again, here globally, 821 million, that is 1 in 9 people are undernourished. So in South Asia, it is 277.2 million. Okay. So summary, we will see the steps needed to end all forms of hunger and malnutrition by 2030. So promoting sustainable agricultural practices or sustainable agriculture. Now, better agricultural investments, providing agricultural subsidies and incentives and supporting small-scale farmers, equal access to land, technology and markets, promoting child and women healthcare, prioritizing nutrition programs, boosting the production and consumption of climate-resilient native nutritional crops, international cooperation to ensure investment in infrastructure and technology to improve the agricultural productivity. So these are some of the measures which will help us to achieve this target of eliminating hunger and malnutrition by 2030. Again, we will repeat: sustainable agricultural practices, investment in agricultural sector, agricultural subsidies, incentives to the farmers, then equal access to land, technology and markets, and promoting women and child healthcare, prioritizing nutrition programs, boosting production and consumption of climate resilient agricultural practices, that is sustainable agricultural practices, and international cooperation to ensure investment in infrastructure and technology. So these are the things. Now you can subscribe to our channel if you have not, and also for the details of online courses, you can visit our website or call to this number. Thank you.